Hi Sagittarius, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do a reading for September. This is for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Keep in mind this reading is being recorded in August, but it is for September. A lot of people, they just don't get it, and I'm not saying that it's you. I just have to point this out. They watch it the day that they watch it, and they're like, oh, that doesn't resonate, not realizing that this is a preview. So just really keep that in mind, and I have to explain that because a lot of people just don't get it. So this is for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus for September. What do we have? We have some sort of news that is arriving, the Eight of Wands, triumphant news, okay? Probably good news. Something is going to arrive very, very quickly, some sort of messages that may make you feel good, okay, because the wands are passion. I feel like you may be a little overwhelmed at this time. You may feel like you got too much going on. You may feel like you got too many demands. I saw the Ten of Wands as well. Justice. So there's something that may be turning out in your favor. You may be getting justice for something. There could be some legal issues on the table here. I feel like there is some sort of decision that is being made, or there's a final decision that is being made. There's some sort of heaviness with the Ten of Wands and the Justice. This is a heaviness, okay? You may be feeling a heaviness over a legal decision or over a decision that was made, okay? I'm not sure if it went in your favor or not, or if it's going to go in your favor, but there is some sort of, perhaps there's some sort of legal contract that is coming to a finalization of some sort. I'm not sure. You're probably seeking balance. You're probably feeling overwhelmed and you're seeking some sort of balance. Four of Cups reversed, I feel that is letting go of regret, the end of stagnation. It's time to look forward. So if you've been dealing with some legal issues, it's time to look forward now, put that behind you. You probably have a new opportunity with the Four of Cups reversed. This is a new opportunity. So you may have a new opportunity. And I think whatever's happening is it's going to happen really fast. Things are going to change really fast. The Chariot. So now I see the Chariot, which is heading in the right direction, forward movement again. So moving forward, you guys are heading in the right direction. There's some sort of driver's seat, putting yourself in the driver's seat. Maybe you're going to get a new job that puts you in the driver's seat. I don't know what the cat that is, if that is for you, but I see you guys moving very quickly in the right direction, whatever that means. And that is in both the Chariot and the Eight of Wands is triumphant. It really is. So there's and maybe if there is some legal issues, maybe you will win. I'm not sure. Let's see what comes out. But whatever's going on, you are heading in the right direction. And it looks like you're headed towards something that is going to be successful. What do we got for Sagittarius? Some major new beginning is on the horizon. I just saw the World, okay? A lesson. Maybe you had to learn some sort of lesson. A lesson has been learned with the World card. And now it's, you know, starting over, starting on a new lesson. There's some sort of completion here. You have a major new beginning, starting over. Sagittarius. What do we got for Sagittarius for September? September. Judgment. So there could be a court case. There could be a court case or a legal issue that where the judgment is finally going to be made. Because justice is finality. Now, justice is a card of karma, and this is a card of karma. So somebody could be dealing with a karmic contract of some sort. Maybe it's a karmic lesson, because the World is a lesson. So this is awakening. This is an epiphany. This is a judgment. You know, I really feel like this judgment is going to go in your favor. I'm not sure why I feel like that. I think the truth is going to come out. If you've been worried about the truth coming out, I think the Moon reverse, the truth is about to come out. Forgiveness, perhaps. There could be forgiveness, like somebody could be forgiving you or you could be forgiving them. Judgment is a card of absolution. And 10-10, completion. And so we definitely have some sort of completion here, a completion of something. And some sort of truth, again, with that moon reversed and the judgment card, some sort of truth is about to be revealed, come out. Four of Wands. Now, this is a card of happiness, bliss, commitment, a new door that is opening. So, this is really good. There's that moon. There's something you don't know, though. There's something that you don't know, something that you don't see. Not all has been revealed. There could be some fear of the unknown, because this is fear and this is the unknown. Unrealistic, dissatisfied. So you may be dissatisfied with something. Let's figure out what we're talking about here. You may feel like you're bound by something. Fear, perhaps. I'm not sure. King of Cups. You could be dealing with somebody who is cold, unemotional, withdrawn, secretive. This is seizing that. There's the Four of Cups reversed. This is seizing a new opportunity. Did I mention that? I think I did. Right now. This is your now position. You probably are going to be looking forward and seizing a new opportunity, but there is some fear here. There's fear of this new opportunity, but we got some emotional fulfillment here. Decision is absolutely being made. We have a decision. You could be dealing with a boss or somebody that is, this is a lawyer or a judge. I'm not sure if you guys are going to court or something like that. There is some sort of decision that is being made that you may not be aware that this is going to give you another opportunity. Your hopes and fears, or not your hopes and fears, this is your challenge position. Being kind, be kind, be gentle, don't withdraw. Be happy. Your challenge is, you know, mastering your emotions, okay? Because it feels like we have somebody here that is not mastering their emotions very well. There could be some addictions, okay? There could be some addictions that are affecting your happiness. Just keep that in mind, okay? There could be some addictions that you need to deal with. They're making you make bad judgment calls. This is what I feel. I feel as though this is being enlightened, taking a time out, taking a break. It's time to refocus. It's time to go within. It's time to replan. It's time to seclude yourself and come up with another plan. I feel like you've gained some sort of wisdom through some sort of bad judgment call. I feel as though you are going to receive emotional support from somebody who really cares for you. I feel like externally, you are dealing with somebody who is very direct, somebody that is very judicial. This person is—it's like this person is all about the law. This person is all about the truth. This person delivers the truth. So I'm not sure if this is a lawyer or who it is, but this is somebody who is very, very matter of fact. Anyway, I feel like your approach is to be quiet. Just be quiet. Okay. Just be quiet. Just be quiet. Let this person take charge. Okay. I think we got somebody here that needs to really hush, 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 hush. You know, just be happy. Just be happy. Master your emotions. Act with kindness. My advice to you is to just be quiet and be kind and be gentle and don't invest in the nonsense. You know what I mean? It feels like you, there's some pettiness, and I don't need those cards. I feel like you got some people around you that are petty, that are childish. I don't need any pages. I feel like you need to really just listen. Just listen, be quiet, keep to yourself. You're probably dealing with somebody who is testing you. This person is investigating you. They're watching you. And this is an opportunity for you to start fresh. Take it as an opportunity. Make sure that you don't shut down emotionally. Be open. Be kind. I don't know where that message is coming from. You're going to, you know, in over here, this is your hopes and fears. Love. Love. So you got the Ace of Cups. This is an emotional. Somebody is going to offer you an emotionally fulfilling opportunity to start fresh. But in order for you to completely start fresh and start over, you're going to have to not focus on what happened, not focus on the loss. You're going to have to make some changes. You're going to have to Mum is the word. I really feel like mum is the word. Just listen. Just listen. Four of Swords reversed. This is exhausted. Frustrated. You may get frustrated. You may get frustrated this month. You're probably dealing with an untrustworthy individual that is really, really testing you. I feel like you are going to be tested, and you're going to need to be, don't rush into anything. Don't rush. This could be at work. You could be at work and maybe you're moving too fast and you need to slow down. Yeah. Okay. So you have an unexpected opportunity. You have a new unexpected opportunity here. You do. And I think this unexpected opportunity, you totally, totally don't expect it, just so you know. You don't expect it. You weren't planning on it. I feel like you have somebody that is wanting to offer you something. And maybe this is you being firm. Maybe you just want to be alone. Maybe you don't trust anybody. You know, that's probably what this is too. Maybe you don't trust anybody. Maybe you don't dare to open yourself up. I feel like you have an unexpected opportunity coming in for love, but there's mistrust here. There's distrust. You don't trust anybody because maybe you were lied to in the past. You were deceived. I feel like you have an opportunity. A new door is opening for a new emotionally fulfilling situation that could really make you happy, but you probably don't trust anybody because you've been lied to, you've been taken advantage of. You definitely have a new opportunity here, Sagittarius. There's no doubt. A new enterprise. You could be getting a new job or a new position. This is a message from somebody. This is a message from somebody that gives you a new opportunity to build something that will be emotionally fulfilling, where you will probably partner up with somebody and it could turn into a love connection. But this person doesn't fit your usual type. This person is unusual to you. It's not what you asked for. You notice she's looking up at that angel and she's like, what? This isn't who I asked for. This isn't what I asked for. And this angel is like, yes, this is what I got for you. So I feel like you are going to have an opportunity that could really make you very, very happy, but you are going to have to commit to it. You're going to really have to focus and commit to it for it to grow. So I feel like there's been a lack of commitment. There's been a lack of nurturing, and that's why something didn't grow in the past. And I feel like you are going to be presented with a golden opportunity to basically start over, but you're going to have to not be so hasty. You're going to have to be not so impulsive. You're going to have to go slow. You're going to have to be kind. I'm not saying that you're not kind. Okay, I'm not saying that. I'm just telling you what I see. You're going to have to be quiet. And I know that's hard. It's really hard. You're going to have to, you know, show your kindness to others. Really, really open your heart. I'm not saying that you don't. And that's when I'm saying this. I'm not saying that you don't. But this is an opportunity for you to start over. And this opportunity to start over is going to lead you towards something that you are going to absolutely love. So give it a chance. It feels like you almost don't want to give it a chance because of, for one, fears of being taken advantage of, fears of getting hurt. There's mistrust here or distrust. Somebody may want to have a relationship with you, you know, but if you're cold and withdrawn and you're angry and you're upset and you can't master your emotions, then we got a problem here. Just being honest with you. I feel like you have an unexpected opportunity that could really, really, really lead to something solid, stable, and emotionally fulfilling if you can take your time with it. Take your time. And I feel like you guys get frustrated because things go so slow. Slow and steady wins the race. Slow and steady things become stable and secure. Wait, think about this. When you are speeding, you think about when you're speeding, what happens? You either get in an accident or you get a ticket. It costs you money. Somebody gets hurt. You need to slow down. You need to slow down and let something take time. Take your time. Learn new things. Okay? So anyway, I feel like rushing has gotten you into trouble. Impulsiveness, anger perhaps. There's some sort of anger here. Retaliation. So if, you know, you got to just be quiet, be humble. This is be humble. Be humble. Just do your job and let whatever is meant to be. Don't fight it. I feel like a lot of times you guys fight things. That's what I see. Don't fight it. Let it happen. You know, take baby steps. Anyway, I feel like there's an opportunity here that you did not expect, something that could make you very, very happy, and you need to give it a chance, okay? I think that you guys have learned some sort of lesson. I think it was a big lesson, and I think that mom is absolutely the word. You may have gotten yourself into trouble. Somebody may have gotten into trouble, and moving too fast, being too hasty may have gotten somebody into trouble. But you have a new passionate opportunity here. This is a new spark, a new vision, a new opportunity, a new exciting opportunity to start over, start fresh. So I feel like you are about to be given an opportunity that could grow into something that you could be passionate about. This could be a new partner. It definitely probably could be. It could be a new opportunity. This is a new opportunity to start over. To start. That's what this is. These are both starting over. This is very passionate, exciting. But you're going to have to not repeat the same patterns that you have been repeating. You're going to have to let go of the regrets. You're going to have to let go of the fear. You're going to have to find your strength and your confidence and your courage to let go of that fear. Act with grace. Be graceful. Be gentle. Be gentle. I feel like you are about to have some sort of unexpected new opportunity, like I said. You're going to have to face your fears about trusting, okay? Trust, believe, have faith. Concentrate. Really concentrate on mastering your emotions. Don't let people see your anger. Hold your head up high and be proud of who you are. You are going to be given a new opportunity that will grow if you put in effort. Whatever has happened has built your character. You have learned a lesson. And if there is some sort of judgment, I think it will probably go in your favor. Be careful not to repeat the same patterns over again, the same mistakes. Be gentle, be kind, be compassionate. You are about to be given a new opportunity to start over. I feel like we have somebody here that is going to, you know, help you. This person is going to help you to rebuild something. You could be dealing with a Leo. You could be dealing with a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, or a Gemini, or a Virgo. I think that you guys have gone through some sort of awakening. You've been enlightened through some sort of hardship. And I feel like you're about to be given a new opportunity. And you probably didn't expect it. Good luck.